हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस्टर मंगेश बले। आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज चवर। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन डिफरेंट सैम्पलिंग मेथड्स फॉर सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैसियस सैम्पल्स। So, in today's lecture, we are going to see different sampling equipments and methods of sampling. Okay. So, into this, mainly we can see two major methods, that is sampling of particulate solids and compact solids. So, first we will see sampling of particulate solids. So the sampling of particulate solids, an important factor to be considered is the particle size, and sampling is done by size to weight ratio criteria of sample size, which is given by size to weight ratio. Size to weight ratio we have seen in previous lecture, which is denoted by small b. So size to weight ratio is equal to weight of the largest particle upon weight of the sample into 100. Okay, so different type of devices are used to sample particulate solids. This includes split tube tip, concentric tube tip, and hand scoop. Okay, these three devices, or you can say apparatus, we can see one by one. So first we will see the split tube tip. Okay, this is the first one. See below, there is the figure of that split tube tip. The split tube tip is a metallic tube which is longer tube with running slot. See it in the figure, there is very long device. Okay, in between that device the running slot is there, empty running slot, and at the right hand side sharp end is there, okay, for the piercing purpose. It is T-shaped handle, fix one end of the tube and another end of the tube is very sharp to remove sample material. Okay, it is T-shaped. See at left hand side hand is there, okay, hand like a T shape. Okay, and in between there is a slot. In this slot there is our sample material will be going inside. The tip is inserted into the container to remove sample with rotating handle. When we insert the sharp end, okay, of this split tube tip into the container, for what? To remove sample. At that time we have to rotate it. Okay, when we rotate the sample present into the container, which is going inside into the running slot, when sharp end of the tip reaches up to center of container, the tip is carefully withdrawn and material is scraped out. When whatever material going inside into the running slot, when we remove that split tube tip from the container, then we have to scrap out our sample material which is present inside into the running slot of that split tube tip. Okay, so this is about the split tube tip. Now we will see the concentric tube tip. This is the second one. Okay, concentric tube tip, it consists of a two concentric tube on fitting closely inside the other. Okay, see the figure of this. This is the figure. See, it consists of a two tubes. At the right hand side there is upper tube which consists of a holes, outer tube, okay, and sharp end. Okay, and in between there is one tube is there. Okay, and at the left hand side there is hand. Again it is a T shaped. Okay, This is the figure of concentric tube thief. Both the tubes have holes at corresponding positions. The outer tube is pointed and pierced in a container to remove sample. The inner tube is rotated so that the holes on it is closed. When the thief is inserted into container and which is reaches at appropriate position, the inner tube is rotated to open holes and material going inside. The inner side holes then close before withdrawing the thief from the container. It is used to sampling cement, powder, granular material, etc. Okay, this is actually the figure of concentric tube thief. See, in between rounded 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, or can say 5 holes is there, that will be present the inner tube only, okay, and outer tube also having holes. When we insert this sharp end into the container of the sample, then we have to rotate with the help of handle, okay. When we rotate the sample going through the holes inside the inner tube, okay, and remove that sharp end from the container and scraped out our sample material. So this is about the concentric tube thief. Now the third one, hand scoop. Okay, this hand scoop, I think everybody knows. Okay, see the figure. Hand scoop, which is useful for collecting a sample from conveyor belt. Conveyor means what? The belt which is continuously moving. Okay, continuously moving, and the sample falls on that belt. Okay, from that belt we can take the sample with the help of this hand scoop. Hand scoop or shovel of suitable size are used to take cross section of particular solid sample while in motion. We will see the example. Ore continuously moving on conveyor belt or carrier belt, a large number of portions will be removed and mixed to give the cross sample. Okay, this is the very easy method to sampling from the sample from the moving belt. Okay, so this is the first one. Now the second, compact solids. Compact means what? Very compact, rigid one. The sample obtained by drilling the sample material. In this case, sampling of compact solids can be done by using different equipment such as auger sampler, geo sampler, split tube thief, split barrel sampler. Okay, now we will see one by one of these four. First we will see split barrel sampler. This sampler is used for drilling equipment to provide deep and clean hole. Okay, it is used to draw samples from mines and wells. See, various mines is there, wells is there. Okay, in that case this split barrel sampler is used for drilling. Okay, when we drill, this sample, compact sample, will be removed from that place. That will be useful for the analysis. It consists of a driving head about 50 centimeter long, made up of hand steel or alloys. That means the whatever hand will be present for this split barrel sampler, that will be 50 centimeter long, and it is made up from steel or alloys. Very strong is there, because it is used for drilling purpose. Okay, that's why it will be very strong one. When it reaches required depths or appropriate position, its blades are open to remove sample material. That means at the top of the end of sharp end, there is blades are there. Okay, When we insert a drill with the help of this split barrel sampler, it will open, that blades will be open to remove sample material. Okay, now the second split tube tip that we have already seen in previous one, it is also useful for collect compact solids also. Compact solid samples we can take with the help of this split tube tip, or can see from gunny bags or similar container. Now third one, geo sampler. The geological survey of any region of earth, the sample is collected in various location. The typical geological sample contains loose soil, rubble, rocks, sand, dust, hard rocks, etc. For this, modern sampling equipments are drills, conveyor belt drills, which is collects specific samples, sample size. Now last one, auger sampler. See the figure of this auger sampler. First of all, this is the auger sampler. In previous equipments we have, or devices we have seen same like this, okay, but see the right hand side, blade like structure is there and it is T shaped, made up from the metal. Okay, when we insert the appropriate position of this auger sampler, it will remove the sample material, that is compact sample. Now we will see the procedure. It is a soil sampler containing T-shaped handle for sampling. It is inserted into the sample material, turned into material and pulled out. The sample material is scraped out with the help of spatula. Okay, with the help of spatula we can scrape out our sample material. So this is about the various sampling equipments and sampling method of the compact as well as particulate solids. Okay, thank you.